company you work for and what city you're in first, if you would, please.
Hi, everyone. My name is John Tsai. I'm with EXP Realty, and I'm from Vancouver, Canada.
Good. And your goal for 2019, both transactions and income, is?
150 transactions and 1.8 million in income.
Okay. And I would ask, what do you have for a team?
One admin right now and two full-time agents and bringing on another couple.
Okay, so one admin and two full-time agents, great. One of the best parts about the country of Canada that you two generally don't enjoy, the country of Canada, which I think is genius, make the transaction very simple for the buyer, the seller, and the agent. Whereas in the United States, it's a complicated transaction. Anything you sell in real estate in the United States is a painfully long, stacks of paperwork transaction. First time you could do 150.
Staying relentlessly consistent.
Say it again.
Staying relentlessly consistent.
Staying relentlessly consistent. Boy, that is something everybody should have done. Staying relentlessly consistent. How do you do that?
Well, I just really focus on the goal and do what the coach tells us to do. I mean, since I've joined you in 2008, I've been prospecting for now, you know, 11 years, right? And I haven't missed the prospecting day since 2012. That's 40 to 50 contacts a day, you know, till today. And no matter how the market goes, it's gonna go up, it's gonna go down. You're gonna have bad news, you're gonna feel happy sometimes, but your actions stay consistent. And so if you want your paycheck to stay consistent, your actions should stay there as well.
So 2012, 2013, 14, 15, 17, 18, 19. Basically, you've never missed a day of prospecting unless you're on a seminar or on vacation. So that is a huge commitment. Now, who wants to take more listings? You see why John does so well? See, it's the consistency that he offers in the industry that gets him the results that he gets. That's incredible. That's Tony Smith-like.
Okay. I think he just missed his first day last year, so I'm going to find a way to break his record.
Good for you. That's great. What's the second thought you have?
Stay out of complacency.
Stay what?
Stay out of complacency.
Stay out of complacency. Now, complacency is when you are satisfied with what you have, whatever it may be. One of the things we've all talked about a lot is when complacency sets in, your desire and motivation to produce diminishes. So, John, we've talked about this many times. You know, he's a young man with a beautiful young wife, two kids now.
One, working on the second.
It's called role play and practice.
Very little practice right now, we'll get there.
And I know his wife, I can see why he wants to role play and practice. She's cute as a wink. So one child, so a young man making a lot of money, how do you stay motivated?
So I've noticed through the 13-year career through numbers analyzers, where I stayed exactly the same income and production was I bought nothing new, there was no life events, and then it was exactly the same. I couldn't break out of it, I couldn't figure it out. And then, you know, inadvertently I do something, like a family change, I buy a new car or whatever, I needed a new one, and the payments went up, and then I see my income spike. So last year when the market went down, I had a kid and we bought a new car, I bought a new watch, and then it was a bad market, but our income went up like 31%.
Sure.
So how do we stay out of complacency artificially, so to speak?
Sure.
In order to push us forward every single year if you don't want to go backwards.
But several years ago, you and I talked about the fact that you've been stuck at one level for a couple of years. So, making the decision to become unstuck was doing some things and taking some risks, like we talked this morning, to get you off of it. You had to buy a bigger house when you had the child. You guys were buying a bigger home.
Bigger home, yeah. You told me that you, in 78 or whatnot, you had $8,000 mortgage payment.
Yeah.
And you were making $4,000 a month.
Yeah.
And I was like, how do you do that? You said, I just did it. I'm like, but Mike, I can't do that. I'm not Mike Ferry. But you said, Mike, to me that you're better. That's what Mike does to us.
Sure. John and I have been very lucky to have some very, probably in-depth conversations about this issue of a young man with a young family making a lot of money, and how do you stay motivated to keep ahead of the curve? And it's a big commitment, okay, to do that. So, first of all, I have to say congratulations, okay? Because anybody here that can defeat complacency has made a giant step forward in their business life. Mm-hmm. So pay close heed and advice to what John has said is thank you. Big round of applause.